Hello friends, I'm Dr. T, Boston's fan of cardiology lifestyle medicine. Today we're going to dive into the fascinating world of blood pressure, demystifying the myths and debunking some fallacies and exploring the ever-evolving landscape of high blood pressure, the silent killer, the leading cause of disability worldwide. And we are answering five questions about high blood pressure, and I'll have a bonus at the end of the video. So grab a seat, hit that like button, and let's get started. What is high blood pressure, hypertension? Before we answer that question, you need to know that 1733, Reverend Stephen Hales measured blood pressure for the first time in a horse, and they connected the tube to his femoral artery of the horse and connected to a glass tube vertically coming out of his neck, and the blood shot up an impressive 8 feet and 3 inches. If you had looked careful at that time, you would have seen that column of blood would oscillate between upper and the lower level. The upper end will be the systolic, the upper normal of blood pressure. The lower would be the diastolic, essentially reflecting the cardiac cycle. When the heart contracts, we have a higher number. When your heart is relaxed, you get a lower number. What is high blood pressure? Is a persistent elevation of this force of the blood against the wall of your arteries. In fact, 116 million Americans, 1 billion people worldwide. What is normal? What's the ideal of blood pressure? What are the recommendations today in 2023? It's a fact that the so-called normal blood pressure has changed over the years, but for a reason. It used to be, we'd consider normal 140 over 90 or less. Today, in 2023, that is not the case. The normal blood pressure is less than 120 over 80. Blood pressure is considered stage 1, 130 over 139, or 80 to 89. Anything above 140 over 90 is considered stage 2 high blood pressure. If you have anything above 180 or above 120, it's called a hypertensive crisis that requires immediate attention. Where did these recommendations come from? Is it fact or fiction? So we've had multiple studies showing that in fact lower blood pressure is better, but a crucial study came out in New England Journal of Medicine in 2015. It was called the SPRINT trial, systolic blood pressure in intervention trial. And essentially, researchers looked at over 9,000 people, compared two groups with different blood pressure targets. One was systolic less than 140, and the other group systolic less than 120. The data is very clear. The study was actually stopped after 3 years of follow-up because the lower group, the group that had a goal less than 120, had a significant impact inducing less risk of heart attacks, less strokes, less heart failure, and less overall mortality. Overall mortality, for instance, decreased by 27%, and congestive heart failure by 43%. We've known some of these truths for a long time, more than 100 years ago. In fact, in 1927, in the Finnish Medical Journal, an article came out, not by a doctor, by an executive of an insurance company. That time showed systolic blood pressure mean was between 120 and 135. And for people who had 12 millimeters or higher, for the average life insurance was actually denied. Why? Because they have increased risk of death. And Northwestern Mutual Insurance Company data from 1907, 1921 showed that each incremental systolic blood pressure of 10 to 14 millimeters of mercury associated with increased risk of mortality, 60% higher mortality. So lowering blood pressure targets, good for the big pharma, but this was not driven by them. What about the elderly? If I'm 82 years old, 84 years old, do I still have to have your blood pressure aggressively treated? In fact, the SPRINT trial did not exclude the elderly. There were 2,600 patients with a mean age of 79.9. And after 3 years of follow-up, on average, they reap the same benefits as the younger counterparts. Less heart attacks, less strokes, and less all-cause mortality. You've been wondering, what can you do about it? So I've personally managed to keep my blood pressure consistent below 120 over 80 for the last 10 years at least. And I've spilled the beans on how to do that in previous videos. Check this one, for example, top ways to lower your blood pressure. I'll put a link above and on the description below. Clearly, research has shown that there is a direct link between high blood pressure and cardiovascular disease. Don't wait. know your blood pressure numbers. It could be a game changer. With every 20 points rise in systolic or 10 points rise in diastolic blood pressure, you're doubling your risk of heart attack, a stroke, congestive heart failure, and even abdominal aortic aneurysm. Your health is the most precious asset. Take control. See you next video.